Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to this After Party for One. I am Jay, the one talking to you. Welcome. This is a tough podcast to get through. I'm not gonna lie. I've watched movies about war. I've read books about war. I've watched documentaries about war. I've seen TV shows about war. I've seen interviews with veterans. I thought I got it. Ah, man, and then I saw the video from Jose that went viral, and I realized like there's something here, something, you know, important. There's an important message here. This guy has something to say. I mean, I'm not even gonna get into his credentials. He gets into that on the podcast. He's the real deal. Jose Belen is Captain fucking America, okay? Through and through. But to see the pain in his eyes while talking to me, to hear the pain in his voice, to some of those stories, fuck, they wrecked me. Like after that podcast, I was planning on getting a bunch of work done. I couldn't. I had to go home, throw in a comedy, smoke some weed. He put mental images in my head that I never want to see in my head again. And he lives with these mental images. He went through the things that he talked about on the podcast. He has to replay that shit in his head. And you tell me after you watch this podcast that PTSD isn't a real thing. It absolutely is. It is. After doing this podcast, I understood something. I've never been a soldier. I've never been to war. I've never enlisted. I've never been in the military. Nothing. I haven't even come close. Okay? There are people in this world who have such vast differences because of their experiences that you can't even imagine how to relate to them after you hear them talk. And I'm going to go on a limb and say any active soldier, any soldier that has gone to war, we have to stop pretending like we get it, because we don't. We just don't understand it. This guy has been through more in his life and his two tours than we will in five lifetimes, because this guy has seen the ugliest side of life, the ugliest side of life, and he's still standing. And the crazy thing is, he's still positive. I was blown away by how positive he was. I get that he's experienced it and he's come through on the other side, and that's probably why I wasn't able to be positive at the end, because the horror of what he was talking about gripped me and held on to me for as long as it possibly could. But the fact that a guy like Jose can come back from all that and be a positive force in this world, I mean, Jesus. It really puts into perspective how minute and small our problems are. Fuck all the bullshit that we talk about all the time. I mean, this podcast literally changed my life. And it's changed it for the better. I find now, after I did the podcast, there's been a few days since, I'm doing what I did when the pandemic hit and I tried to be a better person. And I tried to look inward and say, what's wrong with me and how can I make myself better? This podcast makes me look at the world differently. Jose has made me look at the world differently. A lot of people are talking about, oh, we're turning into North Korea. We're turning into Nazi Germany. It's a war out there. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you. All of you that say that shit. That is disrespectful to the people that fought in those wars. World War II, World War I. Well, not that there's a lot of people around anymore that were in World War I. I don't think anybody's around anymore. I think we have a couple veterans that are pretty old from those wars. I'm not entirely sure, but I think I remember seeing a story about a couple. World War II, the Iraq War, all these wars, regardless of whether you agree with why we went to war, regardless of whether you agree with the politicians, regardless of whether you think it was a trumped up war like Vietnam. A lot of people believe Vietnam was just absolute political bullshit. Doesn't matter when you're having this conversation. Real war is death in the streets. Real war is what Jose was talking about when he said when he'd see kids running to him, they were either A, running to him because they were starving, or B, because they were going to kill him. I'm sorry. I live in Canada. I've lived in the States. I don't know anybody that has ever thought of those things when kids are running towards them. Never. And I think that's the definition of war. The definition of war is when everybody is worried about dying. because it could happen at any moment. Their rights, their freedoms are gone, and their lives have been completely destroyed. Their homes have probably been destroyed. They've lost lots of people. Like, I mean, oh God, the trite shit that we have talked about on this podcast. I will never, ever, ever have a guy like Patrick Allard on my podcast again. That motherfucker pretends like we're at war, pretends like we're turning into a third world country. I would love, love, love Patrick to have a conversation with Jose, because Jose would break it down for him. Jose would be able to tell him exactly where he's going wrong. He is going wrong in the fact that he pretends like we are headed that way. Now I know there are people that lived in communist regimes and in war-torn countries that have come here and said some of the stuff that they're seeing right now resembles what they saw at home. The difference is that there's this core fundamental value that we have here in the West that prevents that from happening here with our own governments overthrowing the people. And that is, we have been given this freedom that we know we have to fight for if someone tries to take it away from us. We have seen those experiences. We are ready. Now, as I said on the podcast, there are a lot of freedoms we've had to give up to deal with this pandemic. And the government has overstepped in a couple of ways. I don't believe they overstepped because they were trying to control us and take over our lives. I believe they overstepped because they genuinely are a bunch of fucking idiots. Okay. However, we don't have to be really concerned about that. We have to fix it later. After this is done, we have to fix our responses to pandemics and major catastrophes. But when we should be worried about these things is when they are taking away our rights and freedoms the way they are during a pandemic, when there's no pandemic. That is when we have to be worried. Until said time, just be a positive force in the world and be a good example. That's what we need to do. We need to be cautious. We need to vote out the people that did what we don't agree with, and we need to make sure that when they run for election, when these politicians are running, when they're campaigning, we have to say, you need to fix these, whatever, five things that were done wrong by the government during the pandemic. How are you gonna fix them? If they don't have an answer, get the fuck out of here. You're not getting into office. Get the fuck out. That's what we have to do. That's honestly where we have to be at, okay? We get to elect the people that make the decisions for us. So we need to stop falling for the bullshit. We need to stop falling for the voice, the outfit, the hair. I've talked about this many times. We need to stop falling for this bullshit, put genuine people into office that believe in genuine ideas, understand that we need to progress, and we need to put people into office that are going to treat us as they would like to be treated. That's it. So for all you people out there, all you people saying that we are living in a war, we're not. And if you can say that after watching the podcast with Jose, please, please unsubscribe to the podcast. Just unsubscribe. I really don't want you, because you are actually doing a disservice to a guy like Jose, who has put his life on the line, who accepted death into his life to make life better for others. Again, you may agree or not agree with the premise of the war he was in. It doesn't matter. What matters at the end of the day in this conversation is that you understand when you make hyperbolic comments like, we're living in a near third world country, we're living in a war-torn country, war is on the horizon, the government is taking away all our rights, blah, 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 blah. You are doing a disservice to a person who actually understands what war is like, who understands what it's like to be in those situations that test your very essence and spirit. I, for one, am a better person because this podcast was done, and I just want to, I have my phone in my hand because I want to shout out a couple things that Jose sent me. Mission Zero Actual, so go on Facebook, it's facebook.com/Mission Zero Actual. There's also a Facebook page for his flags that he was talking about that he's making, the Freedom Factory Flag Co. And actually, Jose reached out to me and said, hey, dude, I've never done a Canadian flag before, but I'm going to do one for you. I'm going to send it to you. I don't want any money. I said to him, make me an American one, too. I'm going to put Canada America up in the background of the podcast. They're always going to be united in the background of the podcast. I think globally we should all be one world. We shouldn't be drawing these lines that we're drawing. Call me a globalist. Oh well. But America is like our brothers and sisters, whereas the other countries are like our cousins or aunties or uncle. We're brothers and sisters with those in the US. And I hope the US sees us the same brothers and sisters with Canada. And I want to put that message out with the podcast. And Jose is going to help that by setting me up with a Canadian and American flag, which are going to be proudly displayed in our podcast. And I also told him, I said, and I hope a lot of people have this kind of perspective, creative people that create something for this world, they deserve some sort of reward. So we're going to be donating, I'll be donating to one of his charities he would like me to donate to as a result of giving me these flags for free. And I'm excited to put them on the wall. So that is it for Shit People Post After. No, wait, sorry, 1 second. So I would like to just end this off with some pictures that Jose sent me. And Jose sent me a lot of content, a lot of news articles, pictures, his time with Montel Williams, some of the stuff he's done, some cool flags that he's made. And we're going to roll with that. We're going to end with all that kind of content. We're also going to end off at the very end with pictures of his fallen brothers that he went to war with that died for freedom. And we're not going to play any music under it. I just would like you guys, out of respect for Jose, out of respect for soldiers, out of respect for those who have fallen, out of respect in general, just take a moment, take those pictures in, bow your head if you believe in prayer. Just really take a second and look at those pictures of those men and boys who died for the West to be free. Yes, the US, and yes, I know I have a lot of Americans, but I got a lot of Canadians that watch this too. They died for the West to be free. Okay, so just take a moment, take it in, really feel Jose's words, and really feel a sense of pride in what it is that these people have done for us. Thank you so much for tuning in to this episode and this after party of Shit People Post. It was humbling, it was rewarding, it was a life changer. I thank you so much. As always, leave comments, and especially on this one, leave comments for Jose. Let him know that we're with him through all of his struggle he's going through as a result of going to war, and that we're with him no matter what, and all the soldiers that have gone to war, that have had to fight and come back to a country or a West that has not been what they expected, has not given them what they needed when they got home, and we're with them to help them through, and we're with them to show them that we love them.